Your business has data that is not being utilized enough. I guarantee if you follow the steps in this video that we're going to share with you, you will increase opportunities, save resource, and speed up your processes to improve business operations and improve your client's experience. Now, imagine this. Cast your mind away a little bit. We're going to go into imagination world and we're going to figure out a nice 5-star hotel. We're just walking across the driveway, coming into the reception. You're coming in, it smells luxurious. Everything's very organized. People are super happy. People whizzing around. It's all run very efficiently. And me, as a customer or a client of that hotel, has the best experience. I'm going to want to come back. I'm going to rave about it to all my friends. Hey, that is what it is like to interact with a data-driven organization. Now, contrast that, right? We're going from the countryside, whizzing into the busy city. We're going into a busy city hostel, right? We're walking in, there's no one on reception. Oh goodness, all right, okay. It's a bit budget, it does the job, and it's a place to sleep, but I'm not really getting that full client experience, right? I'm not getting that full potential that that business could offer me. And that's sometimes what the experience your clients might be having when they interact with your business, because you're not utilizing that data as effectively as you can. So what I'm going to do in this video is going to run you through the 4 distinct stages that you need to follow in order to increase the maturity of you utilizing your data within your organization. It's provided by Dell Computers, and there's 4 stages that take you from data awareness to data driven. Hey, all right, follow me. Let's go have a look at what those stages are. So we start ourselves off here, where most people are, hey? Perhaps you're here right now and you're data aware. Of course you are, right? We're all aware that we need data in order to run our organization. You've got no data, you've got no business, let's be honest. And the biggest businesses in the world, the Googles, the Amazons, etc., they are fully data first organizations, right? So we start in here with data aware. So manually compiling reports is where we're doing stuff in Excel or PowerPoint. Right? So I've got my systems, I'm going in as a business user, I'm logging in, I'm downloading my data manually, I'm going ahead and opening up Excel, I'm copying and pasting them into the same workbook, I'm doing my pivot tables, doing my charts, all that sort of stuff, my VLOOKUP formulas, right? I'm building the reports that I need to, and then I'm cutting it out, doing a little screenshot maybe, lifting, shifting that into a PowerPoint presentation, and I'm creating that manually every single time, right? That's where businesses are nowadays, hey? They're data aware, but they're just manually compiling the data. That's not scalable, right? And of course, if we're manually compiling that data from a source every single time, it's a high risk that that data is not going to be correct, okay? So what we're gonna do is we need to make ourselves aware of how we can get from that first stage, that busy city hostel type experience, into data proficiency. This is stage number 2, right? We've upgraded ourselves to a nice 3-star hotel, right? Because we've not innovated on any new processes, right? But what we have done is we've standardized the reporting within our organization, right? So what that means is we're utilizing tools such as Alteryx Designer. Now here at Continuum, what we do is we search the market across the entire world and we partner and skill ourselves up in the very best technologies available. And what we found is that Alteryx Designer is the best tool in order to standardize and automate your processes, right? So what that means is, if we're going back to that reporting process where we've gotten Excel data and manually compiling it from scratch every single time, what Alteryx does, it doesn't innovate on a brand new process, not yet, but what it does do is it takes that manual process and it standardizes it, right? It automates it. And it goes ahead, right, we're gonna plug into the systems, pull out that data automatically. So therefore, processes that could take you, what, an hour, 2, 3, 4, hey, I've seen processes that take up to a week to complete sometimes. What we can do is automate that processes, increasing the pipelines to all our different systems, and we wanna report on our data, press the button, Alteryx whizzes it through, and in minutes or seconds, not hours, we're getting our data and we're reporting it to whoever needs to see it, whether it's management stakeholders, whether it's your clients themselves, hey? So that is data proficiency. Now, once we're proficient in our data and all of our processes are standardized, they're repeatable, they're robust, hey? They're watertight now, we're gonna move on to the next stage. This next stage is called data savvy. Hey, we've upgraded to 4-star now, hey? We're pretty good with our data, we're pretty savvy. We're not entirely data driven just yet, but we're making progress along this scale, right? We've got our manual reports, we've standardized them, they're automated. Now we can start to utilize stuff like the Alteryx server. Again, we're with Alteryx, and it's another product they offer. The Alteryx server here, the benefit that provides is we're taking these solutions that have been developed in the data proficiency stage and deploying them to a server environment. Now, what that means is even if your line of business teams in Alteryx themselves, they can run the processes here, but we're actually taking those processes and deploying them onto a portal. And that means that management, stakeholders, even your clients and customers themselves can become self-service in interacting with those portals to pull down the data they need themselves, right? Increasing that experience. No longer do they have to put in a request and say, hey, can you run that report for me? No worries, it's on the server. I find it myself, click and execute the process. I've standardized those reporting and now I can become self-serving and even start to do a schedule to kick off processes automatically whenever I want. Now, also within the data savvy stage, we can have Alteryx driving Power BI, right? Now, Power BI is a fantastic data visualization tool. Lots of people use it, right? We're on Office 365, a lot of businesses nowadays, and a lot of people are starting to play around with visualizing their data in Power BI. And there's tremendous value in doing so. However, what a lot of people find quite quickly is it takes a long time to get any of these visualizations live. 3, 4, 5, 6 months. It can take sometimes, in my experience, to get a Power BI visualization live, right? And by that time, the scope or the requirements of the visualization probably have changed, hey? So what this does is we take Alteryx here, which if you want to learn a bit more about it, we've got a video specifically on Alteryx Designer, can take the data and automatically fashion it, get it into a good shape, and pass it into Power BI, so therefore it simply visualizes clean and concise data and not having to go ahead and connect the source and manipulate that data itself within Power BI, which, you know what, is not what it's really designed to do. It's fantastic at visualizing data, but pretty horrendous at manipulating and handling and joining data together. Happens to be where Alteryx excels. Combine them together and you can really become data savvy. For example, a client of ours goes ahead and utilizes Alteryx server and Power BI, connects them together, right? Alteryx goes in, plugs to those sources, pulls the data down automatically on a schedule every 5 minutes. Alteryx handles the data sort of heavy work, picking it up, joining it together, and then it provides it to Power BI in clean and concise data sets, which it can then visualize. So therefore, that client has near live, every 5 minutes, as near live as you need to, right? Every 5 minutes, it gets a visualization refreshed from source with the combination of Power BI and Alteryx server. That is really data savvy, hey? That's that 4-star hotel experience, you might say, hey? Now, we want to get to the 5-star, of course we do. We want to make sure our clients get the very best experience they can get from our organization. And if you want to do that, you need to make sure your organization is achieving this fourth and final stage of data-driven. Now, data-driven means that the data is embedded in all business processes. You see that? No data, no decision. And that's right, because we can then start to utilize fantastic and innovative technology such as IOCR, heard of that? Intelligent Optical Character Recognition. Again, we partnered with the best in the business. They're called nanonets in that respect. And what IOCR does is it goes ahead and unlocks PDF data, right? So you've got data coming in invoices or suppliers providing you PDF data. And I tell you what, I see it all the time. Businesses going into their PDFs, right? I'm gonna copy this, highlight it, paste it into an Excel sheet, highlight next row, put it in. We've got teams of people doing that, hey? Of course, that's not scalable, and that's certainly not data-driven. What Intelligent Optical Character Recognition does is it scours those documents, pulls out the data, and transcribes it into your systems directly. Now, the intelligent part is it's powered by AI, and it's trained on millions of other documents, so it knows precisely where the invoice date is, for example, knows where the invoice address is, their total amount, pulls it out without you need to tell it what to do whatsoever. Fantastic, it's all right. But if we're gonna start to utilize any of this data-driven technology, we need to make sure we progress through these stages, hey? Right, we gotta make sure our data's in good order, make sure it's all connected up. Then we can start to go into this data-driven aspect we got here. What about Alteryx Auto Insights, hey? Alteryx Auto Insights is a phenomenal tool. Got a video specifically on that subject. Make sure you check it out if you want to learn a bit more. But what it does is it complements visualization technologies like Power BI. What it is a data visualization technology itself, but it's AI driven, right? Much rather in compared to Power BI, where you have to go ahead and say, right, I know what I'm tracking. We've got a KPI, whatever it might be, key performance indicator. I want to plot X over Y, and I build the charts accordingly. However, Alteryx Auto Insights says, okay, here's my data. Now you, as Alteryx Auto Insights, tell me what I need to know about my data. And it shows you what you don't know to ask about your data and shows you all the interrelationships between your data points. And actually, can tell you a hell of a lot about your business that you might not have even recognized. Again, that's fully AI powered. And we've got that video specifically on that subject. You're gonna wanna check it out. Next, we got things like just general AI integrations. Hey, I put in the OpenAI logo here because ChatGPT is all the rave at the moment. Of course it is, but of course there's other API technologies that are available as well. We can start to blend these AI technologies into our systems as we start to standardize our processes, got them watertight, and then our data is reliable and repeatable. We can then start to interact with these services. And finally, we might even strive and get ourselves towards time series forecasting and machine learning. We partner with fantastic guys at Tangent Works, and they're the best in the business in that respect. And what this means is I've got my data, I want to cast my mind into the future and forecast what's going on in my business. I want to look forward so I can stay ahead of the curve and the competition, right? But of course, you must realize the data's got to be secure because if you're putting that bad data into those forecastings, the forecastings are of course going to be misleading, right? So these are the four stages you need to follow. These are the distinct steps, and these are some of the technologies that can take you along the way. Now let's summarize precisely what these steps are trying to tell us. So step number one, remember that? Data aware, we got manually reporting all of our data. We're going in and doing the same stuff in Excel, hey? Right, that's our busy city hostel. Getting ourselves upgraded, 3-star hotel, here we go. We're cleaning up our data, right? We're not innovating on anything new. All we're doing first of all is taking all of our processes, cleaning them up, getting them standardized, getting them repeatable, right? Making sure they're not error prone and increasing the confidence we have in our data. Next, we're upgrading again. Ooh, 4-star hotel now. We're getting pretty swanky, okay? We're now accelerating, okay? So what we've done, we've got all our data, got it secure, it's robust, and we're speeding up now, okay? We can confidently and successfully speed up our operations because our data is clean and concise and repeatable. We have to make sure we go for that proficiency stage first of all. Once the data is repeatable, once we've accelerated our processing, then we can fly to the skies. Hey, we're going to utilize our rocket now and start to innovate on all these magical things we can do with all these fantastic technologies that are coming out. That are AI powered, time series forecasting, you name it. You can get involved. However, what I see clients doing is they start in the data awareness. It's okay, yeah, we've got Excel reports we're smashing together, and I want to utilize all this fancy AI technology. Let's go from awareness to data driven immediately. You can't do it, and it begins to have a floppy foundation, and people try to jump up that quickly find out they're going to fall over, right? You need to make sure you take the time, go through these stages individually, clean everything up, standardize it, speed it up, and then we're going to go ahead and innovate. So if you want to learn a little bit more, then of course check out the rest of our channel's videos, or if you want a one-to-one consultation on precisely this methodology, get in contact with the details within the video description. Now, we mentioned Alteryx a lot in this video, and it's a phenomenal tool. You might not know a lot about it, but if you want to learn more, you're going to want to check out this video right here, where I go into detail on precisely what the product is and what it can do for you.